Hi and welcome everyone to this Ignite webcast. My name is Josh Topal and I work on the Office 365 team. Ignite events are a series of technical workshops for IT professionals and Microsoft partners, and the Ignite webcast series will address different technical subjects and scenarios that are really beneficial to anyone who wants to increase their knowledge of the Office 365 suite. So today we're really excited to have Stasia Snap lead us at this webcast. Stasia is a senior content developer at Microsoft, and in today's webcast, she'll be digging into setting up domains in the Office 365 portal. So today's session provides a really great opportunity to hear directly from someone at Microsoft who's worked so closely with the product for such a long time. And today's webcast will be about an hour, and we're going to leave a few minutes at the end to field any questions from anyone on the call. So you can go ahead and type your questions into the link chat box window, but I do ask that you wait till the end for the Q&A section so that we can address all your questions. One final thing is that we are recording today's session, and we'll have the slideshow that you see here and the recording available on the Ignite site, specifically on this event page, which you can see right there that I pasted. And since we are recording today, please understand that you may be captured in today's recording. So if you don't wish to be recorded, please don't type into the IM window or feel free to leave the call and you can watch the video recording at a later time. So that's it for me. So whenever you're ready.
Okay. Can you hear me, everybody? I assume you can.
Yep.
I'm Snap and I work at Microsoft. I've been here for quite some time now, and I've worked for the past several years on the Office 365 suite, particularly in the domains area and adding domains in the Office 365 suite. So I'm happy to be here today. I'm glad you could join us, and let's get started. Before we really dig into the topic, I want to make sure we have this scoped correctly, because domains is a really big area, even for just with the Office 365 suite, and I want to make sure we stay focused today so we can cover what we need to cover. And there's other Ignite webcasts and lots of other content that cover other areas of domains. But so there's a domain setup. Here's some of the other areas that domains touches on. Hybrid deployment, where, for example, you may be setting up Exchange locally and also integrating that deployment with the cloud. So we're not going to touch on that today, but there's lots of other information out there. Exchange Online Protection, or EOP, is another area that where you're working with domains. Setting up your Office 365 public website also involves domain setup, and you'll use your custom domain that you've set up in the suite for that. We're not going to dig into the details of that today. And then also for your user management, obviously your users are going to be using that custom domain for their email addresses, and we're not going to dig very deep in that area either. But what we're going to focus on is just getting that domain set up in your suite, and so you can use it for all these other areas. So why would you want to add a custom domain? So when you sign up for the Office 365 suite, you get a couple of domains right away so you can get started. When you sign up, you type in your organization name, like our classic Contoso, and then we use that to give you a domain that you can use right away. It's the onmicrosoft.com domain. So that you can see it set up there, where you type in your account name, you type your user ID, and then we'll create that domain for you. So that gives you an email address you can use right away, a public website address that you can use right away, and the team site's address is set up for you as well. So that's awesome. You can get started right off the bat. And if you just want to use team sites for collaboration, for example, you can just dive right in and start using those. But if you want to start using email or your public website, you probably want a more professional and friendlier domain to work with than this contoso.onmicrosoft.com. So you might want to change it to just, for example, contoso.com. And you probably want your public website also to have a shorter email address that aligns with your business, like contoso.com. So this will help you get started doing that by adding your custom domain. Another thing to note is that your email address is also your user ID. So that'll make it easier for with sign-in information, not typing that long Microsoft.com domain as well. So how do you get started? When you're setting up your domain in Office 365, it requires a couple of steps. Basically, you first need to verify to Office 365 that you own the domain name. Then you're going to make sure that any existing email and websites that use that domain don't break, because that would be bad news. And then you'll set up your services with email, website, and link, whatever services you've signed up for. So some of these steps are on the Office 365 portal, and some of them are on your domain registrar site. And that's what makes things get a little complex, is that you're kind of going back and forth between doing work in the portal and doing work on that domain registrar site. So one thing we try to do is to help people who don't work with DNS very often to finish this work successfully. If you work with DNS a lot, you know exactly where to go on your registrar site. You can update those records as long as we give you that information. And it's pretty straightforward, even if it takes a little time. People who don't do this very often may not even remember what their domain registrar site was. It can be a little more complicated. So we try to do some hand-holding in the suite and kind of ease you into this and walk people through it so they can be successful in getting this set up. The way you set up your domain is a little different for small business and enterprise. They're very similar processes. You still need to have a custom domain. You still need to add that domain in the, to the suite. You still have a domain registered at the registrar. But then, if you're a small business, you can have Office 365 manage that DNS for you and get the record set up. If you're an enterprise or a small business, you can manage that DNS yourself. So small business has the option right now to let Office 365 do that setup for you. In enterprise, you'll always need to do it. So it gives you more flexibility, right? If you're managing your own DNS, for the small business, some people may prefer to have all those records set up for them. So you start the process the same way. This is a small business example, but it's very similar in both types. So you type in the domain name that you want to use, and then we ask you a couple of questions. We want to make sure we understand what your scenario is so that we can make sure you complete all the steps that you need to, and so things won't break. So, for example, we'll ask you which option you want to choose. Do you want to manage your DNS yourself, or do you want Office 365 to manage it? And that will influence the kinds of steps that you're going to complete. And then we want to know whether you are already using that domain name for email addresses, and whether you already have a website out there, a business website that uses your domain, because we don't want that it won't break, but it won't be accessible from your domain once you add it to Office 365, unless you take a few extra steps. So based on your answers to those questions, then we create a set of tasks for you to complete. And it looks something like this. So here you see there's 5 tasks to complete. There may be only 3 or 4. It depends on what you need to do in your situation. So as we talked about, you first need to verify your domain. Then we're going to walk you through some steps that will make sure your current website is still accessible from when you type that domain name in. If you have Office 365 email addresses already set up, we'll make sure that you move those to your domain and that those keep working. Otherwise, after you move your domain over to Office 365, the email will start coming to Office 365, but your users may expect it to be going to where it's going right now. So we want to make sure that's handled smoothly so that they don't feel like they've lost their email. Then you can add new users with your custom domain. It's a handy place to do that. You don't have to do that at this point, but it's just a nice thing to do while you're in here adding your domain. And then typically, if you're a small business, you'll switch your name server records over. That tells your domain tells the internet where to look for your domain when it's going to route email or your website address. And once you switch those over, then we'll set up all the rest of the DNS records for you. If you're an enterprise, then or you choose to manage your DNS yourself as a small business, then you'll be setting those records up yourself at your domain registrar. So you can see that each of these different tasks has a different step in the wizard, and you complete them one at a time. So first of all, you'll do that first one, and when you're done with it, you'll see a little check mark next to it that shows that you're done. If you take a break, sometimes this takes a while, and if you need to take a break, when you come back to this, those will still be checked off, and you can start up right where you've left off so you don't lose your place. Let's look at just the first one of these steps, which is verifying your domain. So why do you need to verify your domain to Office 365? It's kind of a laborious process, so why do you have to go through this? Well, we want to make sure that when you add a domain name, you could type in anything you want there, right? So we want to make sure that you really own that domain and that you're going to be able to use it with Office 365 before you get started with this. So, for example, if someone else typed your domain name in here, they wouldn't be able to verify it because they won't be able to create this record over on the domain registrar site that we'll then look for to make sure that you own it. So you'll click that link to get started. And the first thing we'll want to know is where do you manage the DNS for this domain? Because you're going to go create a record over there, usually a TXT record, and then we're going to go look for that. And when we find it, we'll say, ah, you must own that domain because you had the privileges to sign in there and create that record. So you choose a domain registrar from this drop-down list, where it says DNS hosting provider. It may be a hosting provider or maybe a domain registrar. Sometimes they're the same. Sometimes it's you host your DNS at another site. And the next thing you'll see is a list of instructions for how to create that TXT record. So if you work with DNS a lot, you know what a TXT record is. You probably know exactly where to go and add that record at your DNS hosting provider or your domain registrar. But if you haven't worked with this much before, or it's been a long time, or maybe you never have, we want to make sure that we give you all the explicit instructions for creating that record. So you'll go to this page and you'll scroll down. You can actually print it off if you want to. And this will let you, it gives you screenshots and lets you actually walk through exactly what you'll be doing. So you'll be going back and forth between the Office 365 suite and this domain registrar site where you'll be following those steps. This can be a little confusing to people, and it's just part of the way DNS works that we have to go off to this other site to be doing this work. So after you create that verification record, you'll come back to the bottom of this page. You can see where you're finishing up those steps there. And at the bottom, you'll see Done Verify Now. You click that button, and after you've waited a few minutes for DNS to do their updates across the system, Office 365 will go out, find that record with the right information in it, and say, yep, you own that domain. You're good to go. And then when you come back to your page again, you'll see that that check mark is checked off and you're ready for the next step. So that is a lot of steps to that, and we know it, and we know it can be challenging. So we've tried to find different ways to make this easier, and one that we've added recently is if you have a GoDaddy domain, we can make it much easier. So one of the first things we'll do is detect, oh, you do have a GoDaddy domain, and we'll give you this little message saying, because you have a domain at GoDaddy, we can do the setup for you. So you'll sign into your account right from the portal and click a few more verification dialogues, and we'll be able to verify it straight away. You don't have to wait for updates across the internet. You don't have to do all those steps on your domain registrar site, and you're good to go. As a bonus, we also can do all that DNS setup for you. So you're going to need to update, particularly if you're an enterprise or you choose to manage your DNS as a small business. You'll need to be adding different records, your Amex record and CNAME record, SRV records, different records for your domain to make everything work correctly for all the services, for email, for your website, and for link. And that can take some time too. So if you have a GoDaddy domain, we'll do all that setup for you. And not only is it faster and easier, less time consuming, but it's all done correctly. It's easy to make typos when you're working with all these records. Believe me, I've been there, done that. And so this really makes it not only faster, but much smoother, and then you're good to go. So we encourage using that GoDaddy domain if you can, just because it makes it so much more straightforward. We realize not everyone can, but this is another option that you can use. So why are there so many steps to setting up a domain? You might think, as I did when I started this, why can't I just have a little drop-down where I say, this is the new domain name I want to use, why, change my email address to this, click next, and I'll be done. But as you've seen, it's not quite that straightforward, unfortunately. And one reason for this, the main reason really, is that using a custom domain means working with DNS and all its ins and outs. So there's detailed steps you have to follow, and you have to wait for the updates across the system. It just can be the DNS system developed over time in kind of an organic way, and it works pretty well for what it does, managing all these domains across the world, really. But it does take some kind of tricky, finicky work to get it all to work, particularly when there are delays across the system and things haven't updated when you expect them to. Another challenge with this is that all the domain registrar, anyone can like set up a domain registrar site and allow registration of domains, and there's dozens of them out there, probably hundreds. They all look and work very differently, and as a customer, the great thing is you can choose where you want to register your domain. That's a great option. You can choose the services that you want. But when we're trying to make sure you own the domain or get the record set up correctly, we don't know which site you've chosen. So we have to help you do that setup successfully, no matter where you have it registered. So we provide a lot of steps for a variety of different registrars, and we make this as simple as we can. But again, that adds some complication because we don't own that set of pages. We have to work with what's out there. And they change, of course, so then we need to keep those steps up to date. Another challenge is that our customers have a wide range of experience. So some of them work with DNS and domains all the time, particularly partners and people who work in large enterprises. This may be something that's just part of their daily job. So what they want is something very quick and fast to get through these steps. They know just what to do. They just want to know the values and where to add them. But other people, like I say, have not worked with DNS maybe at all. Maybe someone else set up their website for them and their email for them years ago, and they pay their domain registrar every year to renew that domain name, but they haven't had to go to the domain registrar site for a long time, if ever. So for those people particularly, we really want to help make sure they have this smooth hand-holding experience to help them be successful in getting things set up. So that, again, adds steps that needs to be followed. And then another challenge in all this is that some people, of course, are already using their domains for websites or email outside of Office 365. And we want to make sure when they transition to the suite that that's a smooth transition, that they can get their domain set up easily, that nothing breaks for their email that they obviously rely on, that their website is still, they can still get to the website that they have up and running. So it takes some work, like a handshake between us, to make sure that they're giving us the information we need so we know what their scenario is, and that then we can guide them through the steps that will help that be successful. So this has been a challenge for a long time, and it's not unique to the suite. It's something that everyone who provides a custom domain offering wrestles with. And so we continue to update the service and try to make this easier all the time. So one thing, as I said, we've done recently is we've added this automatic verification and setup working with GoDaddy domains. So every domain registrar has their own unique way that they work with DNS, and so it takes a partnership to make that, to provide an automated service. And we have this partnership with GoDaddy. So that's awesome, and it really makes things really quick and easy when you can use that GoDaddy domain. So that's been great to be able to get that up and running. Something else that we now offer is that if you don't have a domain yet, you can buy a GoDaddy domain from right inside Office 365. And that's offered in the enterprise and mid-sized business now. And we're always improving our service, so we'll be, of course, hoping to expand that service as well. So that lets you, if you don't have a domain yet and you want to have a custom experience, you can buy it from right inside the suite. And something else we offered recently was the ability for small businesses to manage their own DNS records outside of Office 365. So as I said earlier, typically for a small business, you want Office 365 to manage that DNS for you, get the setup done, especially if you don't have a GoDaddy domain, because then you don't have to worry about SRV records and auto-discover records, getting everything set up, understanding and getting things set up correctly. But we've heard from our customers that even if you're a small business, sometimes you still want to manage their own DNS and have that flexibility. There were ways to do that previously in the product, but it was kind of a not a smooth experience. So we recently added the ability to, in the wizard itself, choose the option. Do you want to host your DNS yourself outside of Office 365 and keep it there? Or do you want to move your domain over, the name service point over to Office 365 so we can manage it for you? So those are just three things that we've done recently. As I say, we've been making improvements regularly over the years. And now that we have a service with a monthly service, it makes it pretty easy. We can roll these out as soon as we can get them done and test it. So that's awesome. So we do roll out updates regularly to the service, as you know. And we've made a number of improvements over time. But domain setup is a known challenge area. Take some time to do, and making this easier is a really top priority. So we continue to work at this, and we look for feedback from our community and from people who are who have worked with this area to. So if you have ideas, please feel free to post in our community forums and let us know or give us feedback in other ways, and we can we'll keep aiming to please. So this has gone really quickly. I'm used to having more interaction with my audience when I work with this deck. So we've gotten through this quickly. I have a we'll have a lot of time for questions if people have them. I have offered a number of resources that where you can get more information. We have a lot of help available for the different subscription types. We have step-by-step instructions, as I said, for both when you host your own DNS at a domain registrar site or a DNS hosting site, and if you're setting up the small business where we host your DNS, the verification steps, adding your name server steps, those are also covered in step-by-steps. We have a community wiki as well, where there's some we've gathered some information, and we continue to add updates as needed. And then the community forum, I'm not familiar you are with that, but that's a great option for asking questions and getting support. We have support engineers who look at it regularly and respond quickly, and you can get support from your fellow customers as well. And I look at it pretty often as well, so. That's another great place to go with your specific questions. Working with domains can have a lot of kind of one-off scenarios where something's happening, you're not quite sure why it didn't work or what to do to get it set up right. So that's a great place to go and get some help. And then we have an overview video for the small business experience I just walked through, but it goes into a lot more detail about showing you kind of slide by slide how that what that looks like when you go through that. The domain service description is a great resource. It really details all of the ins and outs of exactly what's offered with each subscription, what you can do, what's a limitation, and it lays it out by all the different SKUs that are offered. So that's a great service. And so here's some other resources as well. We talked about all the different ways that domains can integrate. With different things you're doing with the service. So there's other Ignite webcasts about these different offerings, the hybrid deployment with Exchange on-prem and in the cloud. Setting up Exchange Online Protection. This is a webcast about that. Doing a cutover and stage migration where you're moving people gradually to the cloud and working with your domain is an important part of that as well. And then also setting up single sign-on and working with identities. Again, your domain is going to be an important part of that as well. So I've listed some of those resources out here, and they're available for you. And we can go to questions if we answer this one very fast. So pipe in with your
Great.
questions.
Great. Thanks for the presentation. Again, yeah, now's the time. If you haven't had your question answered, we can go ahead and type it back into the IM window. Again, you can find the video recording and the PowerPoint with all those resources at this site later this week. I'm going to pose a couple survey questions, but Sasha, are you able to see the IM window and maybe
I'm
go through some of
just,
these questions?
yeah, let me just take a quick look here and see what's,
Great.
and it looks like Sanjeev has piped up as well, so that's great. Well, he's going along. Let's see. Somebody is best to copy the, yes. Well, someone typed in it's best to copy the records from the portal and have the domain registrar add them up. Yes, that can be helpful as well. Like I say, there can be a lot of errors when you're trying to copy and paste back and forth, particularly if you don't do this very often. And that's so it's getting your domain registrar involved can be a good option. I can just talk a little bit more too about the enterprise SKU as well, since I focus on the small business there. So in enterprise SKUs, there are a couple of other challenges. In enterprise SKU, for example, you need to have an extra step where you tell us what the purpose of using the domain is, whether you want to use it for email and link or your website. and you can't set those up at the same time in the domain. So that can be a little bit of a challenging point as you're walking through the wizard, making sure you you add your domain first for email and link, and then you go back through again and you add a www domain to get your website up and running with that URL. And once you've added your domain for your public website, you then need to switch it over. It starts out on that dash public domain, which is great when you're just doing design and testing for your website, but then when you want it up on your own custom domain, you'll need to switch it over. So Mary has a question about moving. If you move your domain to Office 365, that everyone has to move to Office 365 for email, etc. This is a question that's come up often because people often want to do pilots, so they want to test out rolling this out. And there are some ways to do a pilot using your domain. It's a little bit challenging. If you want to ping me, I have some content around that, but I need to make sure I go through and finish testing it before I roll it out to everyone. But there are some ways to do that. I'd love to get some people to try these out and make sure that and test them out for me as well. Work with me on testing them. The Exchange online connected accounts, that's the way to go. If you can use those, that'll help you divert your email to begin with, and then you can switch everybody over after you know things are working. Enterprise Sense, is there an issue with having DirSync enabled prior to adding a custom domain? Thanks, Josh. That's great if they can contact you and then they can let me know. Say the tenant is created and DirSync has enabled cloud user to create, then the custom domain is added and others could be updated. So there are particular orders that you need to follow when you're using DirSync. And make sure that it gets set up correctly with your domain and everything rolls out smoothly. And that would be covered better in a DirSync or a hybrid presentation. I'm not as familiar with that area. I know that you need to follow particular steps, but I would recommend, I believe we have a webcast on that. Look at that webcast and see if it's there. If not, I know we have content out there around how to set up DirSync correctly, and that would be, look at how quick Josh is. He's got that webcast posted right in there. And Fast Track, if you haven't used the Fast Track process, that's a great way to pilot. It'll walk you through the steps for making sure you do your pilot first and then rolling out the more complicated areas of your deployment later. So thanks for posting that, Daryl. Anything else anybody has they want to ask about? I'm just going to scroll back and see if there's other things that looks like Sanjeev was doing a great job addressing this as we went along.
And it looks like we have one more question from Daryl, or was that already answered? No.
Well, that's a good question, Daryl. He's asking whether we'll be adding more domain registrars for GoDaddy to do the automatic verification, which, as I said, is a great option. And that's something we're always looking at adding new features and developing better other partnerships with other groups. So we'll certainly be looking at that. We don't have anything that's planned that we can promise right now. But we know that's a really great option, and it makes things much smoother and easier for doing this. So yes, it'd be awesome.
Okay, great. I think if that's it, we might end this call a little early, but we could leave another minute if any final questions are out there. I also recommend you go to ignite.office.com/events to see our upcoming webcast, and we also have the new support webcast series, so you can see any future events that we're going to have there. But yeah, thanks so much, Sasha, for your great presentation. Here's one more question, and then we can probably end this.
So there was just a presentation about Azure and Office 365 that I saw earlier. Isn't there a webcast on that as well, Josh? Maybe that was even, you can find that one.
Yeah, let me look.
Because I was interested in how they work together as well. The Azure team I know has done a lot of work in with the Cloud ID and letting people have a seamless experience. So I would recommend watching that webcast. And then if you have further questions following up with the Azure folks, that's a good question. You certainly can use the custom domain. How that works with setting up in your portal as well. I think you need to make sure that you have you know you're going to be using Azure and you have that set up.
Okay, great. I'll try to dig that up.
Oh, that's, they keep trickling in.
More.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good.
Are we supposed to configure EOP with Office 365? That's a really good question. The setting up the Exchange online protection as part of the setting up your custom domain in Office 365 can be a little tricky. You need to follow steps in a particular order, and it's been challenging to get to add the steps in the wizard in a way that will help everyone be successful with that because. The way the scenario works, you need to do certain steps in the portal and then certain steps with EOP. And so the best thing to do there is to start with the EOP documentation and steps and follow what they say. Come to the portal and do the domain setup at the point that they say to do it, and then go back and do the EOP work. That's my best recommendation there because it can be confusing if you just start working through the wizard and it starts asking about EOP. It's better to start with the EOP part side of it and then use the wizard as to do the domain part. Anything else?
Yeah. Let me see. If I start talking, maybe another question will come in.
This seems to work, Josh.
Great. Yeah, thank you, everyone, so much for joining. Thank you, Sasha, so much for the presentation. And again, everything will be up on that link and on the Ignite site. So, yeah, I think we can end the call. If you have any questions, my contact info is in the IM. Feel free to reach out to me. All right, thanks, everyone. We'll see you at the next Ignite webcast.
Thanks a lot, everyone. Appreciate it.